Hello, my name is Maria Frahm-Arp, and I'm the Executive Director at the University of Johannesburg Library. It's a great pleasure to speak to you today, and I want to talk about something that I'm particularly passionate about, and that is global outreach in the age of open science. So I think that universities have a very important role to play as we move into an era of open science. And I think we need to be part of the global conversation from wherever we are in the world. And we need to do this in three particular ways. The first one is around research data. As many of us in our different university libraries have set up research data management sites, we need to come up with a universal way in which we catalogue these different data sets, how we manage the metadata, and how we share these data sets. Combined with that is also our role as librarians to help academics understand how to use the data sets that are on our multiple different research data sites. And this can only happen if there is global outreach. So we need to come together, have conversations about this, and work out ways in which we can support our researchers. The second aspect of global outreach, I think, is around transformative agreements. We are all very grateful for the different transformative agreements that we've been able to enter into, particularly those with Taylor and Francis. And we need to continue to work on transformative agreements if we are going to be able to support open science as a global initiative. There will probably become a time when transformative agreements, as they are structured now, will no longer be viable. And so we need to be forward-looking and have global conversations with partners from all over the world and publishers from all over the world to talk about how we are going to create an ecosystem that sustains open science. As somebody working in the Global South, I am particularly aware of how powerful open science is for us as researchers. It means that we have access to things we otherwise didn't have access to. And finally, I think our global conversations are extremely important when we look at open research and open science more generally. How are we going to fund this? How are we going to fund this from the Global South and the Global North? What different things can we all contribute? Are there different platforms that would be easier or cheaper to run from a different part of the world? In other words, I'm suggesting we need to have global conversations in which we begin to think a little bit outside the box, perhaps even throw the box away, so that we can find ways to harness our different abilities, our different strengths, so that we can create a sustainable open science ecosystem in which we can all contribute what we are capable of contributing. We all have so many different talents and insights, and what we can financially afford to contribute, so that we can create a global, sustainable open science ecosystem. So in all of this, you can hear, I'm very passionate about global engagement, global outreach, and creating spaces, voices, ways in which we can all come together and hear each other's perspectives from wherever we are.